All right, we've built an electrical circuit that we're opening a gate. Two motors, we got a motor starter, two timers, a VFD, a limit switch, foot switch, two control relays, a start-stop push-button switch, transformer, power source, and three lights. And so what's going to happen here is we're going to hit the start button. This ball, hopefully, will roll. And it'll roll down this track, hit the foot switch, start our motor starter, our light bulb, and our VFD, which will start our motor. That will open our gate, and the circuit will shut off by the limit switch. And I shall demonstrate.
Got your standard dumb tape that has a twist on it here. What we have is we have two single pull, single throw switches, fuse block, a timer, two control relays, a light, a foot switch, motor starter, and a motor, and the emergency stop down in the bucket. So what it is you'll have your standard person throwing, hit the target, foot switch will activate the timer, give a little delay to the motor. So little Timmy here doesn't quite know when he's going to go, and then the motor will go, the bell will go, and then it'll free fall into the bucket, hit the e-stop, and it'll shut it off, and then next person up will go and take the ride, and Josh will be our thrower. Next up.
Alright, we have an assembly line set up here. It is controlled by that and is delayed by the foot pedals for a time of about 10 seconds. We used all sorts of lights to indicate different things. Emergency stop tripped, belt started, belt running, belt delayed, and manager override. Our two modes are hand for a manager run. Hand is run by the reset button here. Auto for completely automatic run are run by our employees here. That's all I got. So I'll start, James.
Using a couple control relays, transformer, a VFD to control the speed of our motor, and I'm using a PLC to start the motor and to program the flight sequence.
Power.
Nice.
Inputs, one for full mass like that, and then one for half mass.